Today on the workshop, we're going to be taking a look at the brand new USS Grissom NCC-638 and Klingon Bird of Prey from Polar Lights through round two. It's a snap kit. Both are in 1/1000 scale. Let's take a look. That'll be everything inside the box when you get yours. First up will be some nice stands. You can see that for both the standard 1/1000 scale stands that they do include in their smaller ships. Let's get out the Grissom parts. We'll take a closer look at those once we get them out. You can see there is the main hull. We can see the center of the fuselage there. Should be relatively easy to paint. The lines are pretty crisp on there. We've got the other half. And we've got some what looks like nacelles. Now, I'm not a Star Trek expert, so bear with me if I give the wrong name or don't use the exact perfect screen accurate colors. We'll get it as close as we can using the color guide on the box. We'll take a look at the Bird of Prey. This is a nice size ship with a lot of detail in it for its size. Everything can be accentuated with washes and a little bit of weathering on that Bird of Prey, which is what I will be doing. Take a look there. All right, we've got some engines, fuselage, cannons, all those parts. Now, we do have a small tree of clear parts right there, and a big, big, big decal sheet. Let's get it out on the screen, let you take a look at it. We'll do a close-up, then we'll do a full so you can pause it. You can see that it's got registration for numerous other ships on there. So you don't have to do just the Grissom if you desire. But there is the whole sheet. Big sheet of water slides there. All right, I'm going to get the parts cleaned off in the parts washer. We'll be back when I've got some assemblies done. Assembly is going fine. I have used a little bit of glue just because I wanted a more solid hold, but everything will hold together with just the press fit. I wanted to show you in the manual when assembling the Bird of Prey, two things I wanted to show you. One, on step three, when assembling the cannons, the numbers are mixed up. This should be K6, this should be K7. It's not a big deal because they're both the parts that go together, but I wanted to show you that. Also, you can see that this vent and this vent here are two different sizes. You can build the aircraft in attack mode or in cruising mode. It's up to you, and since it's a press fit, you could also change it back and forth if you wished. I'm going to be building mine in cruising mode. I like the wings up on this one, just the way I'm choosing, so that's the way I'm building it. As you can see here, it builds up quite nicely. Now, things I haven't put on the ship yet, I haven't put on the clear tailpiece, and I haven't put in the clear nose piece. Those all want to tint with some Tamiya clear paints, and then after I paint the Klingon warcraft, weather it, I'll be able to snap those in place, and they'll look just fine. But the rest of it is assembled, top and bottom. You can see it looks nice. The only clear part I did have to put in was the underbelly there, and I can mask that off with some Silly Putty, and then go ahead and paint. I'm going to put a black primer on it, then I'm going to paint it with a green surface coat, as close as I can get for my collection of paints, and then we'll go ahead and start painting in some of the wing designs and get that on there. Now my next step is to build the Grissom. So I'm going to put the Grissom together. We'll take a look at that. When I did do the Bird of Prey, I did leave off this rail here that's supposed to be all red. There's no sense in press fitting that into the nose until we do that. And you can see the extra parts left over are those for the attack mode when those plates come down, those grills come down there. So we're going to get the Grissom assembled. We'll come back, take a look. All right, about another 20 minutes, we've got the Grissom assembled. No fit issues, no mistakes in the instructions whatsoever, and it's ready to go. This is ready to paint just as it is. Now, because the underbody is uniquely shaped like that, it would be very hard to get up underneath there and get some paint in it. But because this is a SnapTite model, we can easily just pull the nacelles off. Those are already assembled. And then gently pry the saucer section away from the hull, and now I can take this over to my paint area and get paint on both sides of the hull. I can get it decaled, and then we can just press fit it together. And because the fitting here is so nice, when they go together, once that's together, you're not really going to notice that seam, and where they join together is hidden by the nacelles. It's well designed. So the Grissom I'll be doing in pieces because I want to get paint on everything. That, since I'm not going to be weathering it up or anything, I'm just going to be decaling it, and it's a shiny new ship, I will just be giving it a space gray paint, and we'll talk about that paint later. I'll get that coat on here to make sure it's covered. We'll get the black primer coat and the green coat on the Klingon Bird of Prey. We'll get the details painted. We'll come back during that part of the build. Out of the first coats of paint, things are looking just fine. You can see the Bird of Prey. I painted it on the stand because I have to flip it over and get it all around, and it's a little bit hard to hold on to. That is a nice green color. What I used for that was a Model Master medium green. Very easy to find, very easy to use. For the gray, the very light gray that I wanted to do the Grissom in, you can see the difference between the white and the gray. Of course, I primed it first with a white primer. Then I sprayed it with a top coat of this white gray by Ironlac Sugar. They're sugar paints. You've seen me use those before in the Caterpillar build. I've got the clear red parts tinted. I've got the red ring around the nose of the Bird of Prey painted, so I can go ahead and I can attach the ring around there. Then what I have to do at this point is start hand painting a lot of stuff. What's nice about the inside of the box is it gives you a full view of each side, where the decals should go, and you can see the colors that are used and where they are used in multi-views of the both of the spaceships. So I was going to start on the Bird of Prey. I'm going to get that all painted up the way I want, then I'm going to seal it. Then I'm going to move on to the Grissom, get all the parts painted with the small areas that I need, seal those, put them all together, then we'll be ready to start decaling. Before I start decaling everything, we'll take a look at everything with just paint. See you soon! At this point, most of the hand painting is done. I've got everything detailed. As you can see, the Bird of Prey is all in one piece. I'll be able to start applying decals to that immediately. I did multiple shades of red on the feathers, as I call them, underneath. Did my clear red for the engines. We've got the silvers on there, the gunmetals, the metallics. It all looks pretty cool. All I need to do now with the Klingon Bird of Prey is attach a few decals from the sheet. There's not a lot on there, of course. They don't decorate them up like the Federation does. Then just give it a light weathering with some black pastels. The reason I don't want to use a wash is all the inserts in between like the feathers on there stay green. And if I placed a black wash in there, that would blacken those out and it wouldn't look realistic enough for me. Before I'm all done, both of the bases will be given a flat black shot of paint to cover them up so they don't draw much attention to themselves. But otherwise, we've got the Grissom painted. All right, painted per the box art, and the nacelles, and anywhere you see not painted is where it assembles together, pushes back together. So I have to leave the Grissom unassembled at this point so I can get a lot of the decals attached on the underside of the hull, on the sponsons here, on the other sides, get these larger ones here. I have to be able to flip it, turn it, and if I joined everything together, if I place the top saucer on there, I would not be able to get in there real well and start putting decals on the inside. So, once I'm done getting all the decals on the inner portions and on the under portions of the saucer, I can push them back together, push the nacelles on, glue it to its base, and then start decaling the rest of it. As I go, if I have any issues with the decals, I'll let you guys have a look. We'll see you soon. Decaling, as it has been with most of Polar Light's new Star Trek kits, has been really trouble-free. The Klingon Bird of Prey hardly has anything on it. It's got this crest here, and then on each wing, it's got some of their writing. That's it for decals that go on the Klingon Bird of Prey. Now, if it was in the attack mode, front and back, there are other decals that would be applied in here, but since they're raised up, there is no room, there are no decals that go there. The Grissom, sorry. Lost my train of thought there. The Grissom. The decals are much more numerous. They go all over the ship, top and bottom, like I had described. We will gently flip it over. You can see how they're going on. They're a little crinkly right now because of the fact that I've applied a lot of decal solvent to get them to fit onto those curves. The decals are very thin. They slot on nicely. They do not break easily. They're a little rigid, though. So I've been using MarkFit Strong and standard MarkFit. These are Tamiya decal solutions. They're available anywhere Tamiya products are sold. Usually about $6 a jar, and they last a very, very long time. But you can see all the way around the back and all that, we've got some very, very nice decals that go on there. They look absolutely wonderful top and bottom. We've got insignias. You can see all the little windows on the nacelles. I mean, on the saucer section. Had to paint the little gray areas and the holes in the saucer section as per the directions. So what I'm doing for colors and for guidance is I'm following the box art and I'm following the decal instructions on there. So what I have to do is I have to let this decal solvent dry. Then any decals that stick over the edge, once it's all dry, I will trim away. Then we'll take it over. We'll paint the stands black. We will flat coat both ships and I'll be ready to go. So I've got another probably 10 minutes worth of decal work to do. Then give it a final coat of the MarkFit. Make sure everything shrinks down to shape. Push them in and push them down with a wet Q-tip. And then we will let it dry and we will come back for the final. I will see you soon. And here we are with the final of the USS Grissom NC-638 and the Klingon Bird of Prey in 1/1000 scale from Polar Lights. Now you can see with the flat coat on there and just a little bit of a dusting of a black pastel over the Klingon Bird of Prey. That looks amazing with the different color variations. I went with that green and then a darker green. Now on the bottom of the Bird of Prey, of course, we went with the red tones. Multiple different red tones in there. And it just looks fantastic. I love that. You can also display this with the wings down in attack mode. They do give you the parts for that like I showed you. The Grissom is a beautiful ship. All kinds of bright colors on there, top through bottom. There'll be a slideshow at the end for some better pictures. But you can see that it comes out very well. And they look nice. They come with their own little bases on there. And the decals go on easily. You will need decal solvent for the decals on the Grissom. They do have to fit some different curves, so you want to get them on there precisely and make sure that they push down, but decal solvents are available anywhere you can get model paints and spray paints. So, overall review, excellent kits, nice new additions to the Star Trek universe. In the background back there, you will see the Defiant, and I'll bring that forward just so you can get an idea of the size. The Defiant is also in 1/1000s. So you can see the size of these ships. And of course, if you compare them to the grid on the table while I was building, those are 1 square inch. I'm going to have a little slideshow, so some more detail, so it's not as washed out on the video. But you can see that they are absolutely wonderful. I did not use any glue really to assemble these. They are a snap fit as advertised without problems. They do come with clear parts and the mega decals. Now when you're all done, you'll have a bunch of decals left over to do the Cochrane, the Oberth, the Vico, the Pegasus. So if you ever wanted to change that up, buy another set of kits, you could do so. And it gives you the correct markings for each one. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the slideshow. And we will see you at the next review.